In 2013 alone, the UK saw 90,000 new businesses incorporated. Today, that number has increased by almost 300%, with over 180,000 new businesses coming out of Greater London. Many young people in London today seek to make their fortunes within the tech industry, with thousands of new startups flooding the market with apps, websites, and many other innovations. London is becoming the Silicon Valley of Europe.
Pelinko, get paid with a link. We are a fintech company and we provide payment solution for small businesses. We help them with the collection of payments. That's what we do for small businesses up to from 1 to 3 people. We started the company 1 year ago. We are 3 co-founders and so far it's been so good.
So I'm Alam Sule, founder of Get to the Jobs. I was born in London, grew up in Cambridge, parents originally from Nigeria. And I studied economics at university, worked for a bank, like a placement year, but then after that point I realised I probably didn't want to go back working there, so I went to live in Brazil for 7 months, tried to find a job there. It was incredibly difficult, but managed to work in a hostel, went to the World Cup and Carnival, it was great. I came back and after about 6 months of working as a technology consultant, decided to try and start a business, and then from my experience from Brazil, I came up with Get to the Jobs, the go-to platform to connect youth travelers with paid work abroad.
My name is Rami Darwish, originally Egyptian. A little background about myself, I grew up mainly in the UK and in the British Virgin Islands in the Caribbean, and then I moved over here to finish my high school education, and now I'm currently the third year undergraduate student studying my bachelor's in global business management at Coventry University London campus. So currently my project, as you asked, I'm working on a movie social network.
Damon Siegel. I run Emotio Design Group, which is a partnership of businesses that work from development to website design and marketing, which means effectively we can take people through their entire journey from the beginning of a concept, how to commercialize it, and then how to build it, and then how to market it and sell it to everybody. Working with young entrepreneurs now is fantastic, and it's very rewarding as well from a business point of view. We work with large businesses as well, but it's a different dynamic when you're working for a large corporation. Entrepreneurs, you can see the instant difference that you make in someone's life, putting them on their path, helping them, guiding them through the process.
But I had to go to work one day and I stayed at Fenn's house, so I took the tube and so I went in their suits and just sort of had someone armpit in my face. And at that point, I thought, okay, I need to start doing something else, which allows me to travel, which allows me to sort of do work that I find interesting. It's not just a daily grind kind of thing. And then from that point, I just came up with ideas and get some.
I started a couple of companies before. Lately, we had a hairstyling company that we pivoted to Pelinko. So entrepreneurship has always been in my blood. Even when I was working in corporation like Lloyd's or UBS Bank, I always had that kind of startup approach. So that's why we funded it.
Came to mind when we were sitting one day on the couch and realized, okay, we need to reduce the time spent searching for movies because we spent 30 minutes looking for a movie to watch on Apple TV or Netflix. And then it came, my partner Mohammed Sidi, he came with the idea of inventing an application called Rattle Movies, which works on shaking your phone and based on your preferences, it will give you the movie of your choice. That's really what we base our motto on.
First project. So the biggest piece of advice is don't spend all your money on the application and don't spend too much time and money in the planning of a launch either. You're better off making sure that you build what is a good product, so get your foundation right, but make sure you retain enough money to do the marketing afterwards, because I've seen many projects where they've spent £100,000 on their application and then they have £20,000 to do their marketing. And actually, in reality, if you can do it the other way around, you have a much bigger chance of success. If you can spend, you know, £20,000 on your application and £100,000 on marketing, you're going to reach a massive audience. You'll have a simpler product to start with, but you'll get traction easier because you've got the money to reach them.
If you have a job, don't quit your job. So you can actually overlap the two things for a while, because it takes at least 6 months to put your heads around accounting, finance, setting up the business, find the right talent. So you can do that at night at the beginning. And then when you feel like ready, or not ready, but I would say when it's needed, then jump and actually quit your job and then start your job with probably an office, free office in a cafe, and then start evolving from that, having a few desks, understanding very well the customer needs, finding, like, you know, the product market fit is very important. First of all, it's the founder market fit, if you're really a good fit for that sector or market. And secondly, it's actually if your product is needed. So we need to find that fit, that's the most important thing. You know, screw all that business planning and stuff, you need to do a little bit of that to frame the problem, but it's very important that you actually build something and you put it in front of your customer and get feedback.
Probably just keep going. Like, obviously, when I started, I didn't really know what I was doing. I still sort of don't know what I'm doing to a certain extent. But, there's so many occasions where you think you can't do something, or like there's a problem. But if you just like persevere at it, just keep on contacting people, like, it can get quite disheartening, all the no's you get. But eventually, like, it'll come to a point where you manage to overcome the hurdle, and that's probably the main thing. The grind is probably the main thing.
Most important thing, again, I'd say is connections. Keep your connections open. Do not burn any bridges. And if you have a question to ask or an opportunity that you see in class, for example, on a professor giving a lecture, or even talk to a professor, talk to a consultant. I do the same. I share some of my own problems with the Rattle Movies with consultants in my university. And they give me advice. So just never let down an opportunity and just make sure you have a plan.
Initially, still now it's a bootstrap project, so it's come from all my money, savings, not buying all the clothes that I want to buy. You've got to start small with the resources you have, and hopefully, when you start showing some value, then people will be interested and you can actually get funding from an investor or something like that, yeah.
So that's what we did with Palingo, and we were almost going to jail because we were doing peer-to-peer payments, and there is a lot of regulation with that. There is anti-money laundering regulation, there is frauds, so we actually got some problem on the PCI and legal side, so we had to switch our focus to business to actually be a viable business.
We threw ourselves into the deep end, okay? We had this idea. We knew what our expectations were, what we wanted to achieve, what we wanted for our users, what we wanted the app to symbolize. But when it came down to the operations, the management, the legalities of the business, this is where we needed a little touching up. And so it was me and my partner and an additional three shareholders involved in the company, but mainly my partner and I running. And we were facing challenges and difficulties on a weekly basis. Either, for example, we would have a problem with a developer who couldn't do something that we expected him to do, or is delaying us on something that should have been done, or is increasing our costs for an additional feature that ended up being more complicated than was anticipated. Or, for example, we had a problem with a lawyer where they delayed the arrival of our terms and conditions of privacy policy for the app. So this, in combination with the developer, made us actually have to keep the developer on, making us lose money for keeping them on board for that time period. So in terms of challenges, it can be really random.
5 years from now, I see it as the go-to platform to connect youth travels and paid work. So what we want to be is like, okay, you want to get an apartment somewhere, then you just go on Airbnb. Right now, there's nowhere you can really go where I want to find a job abroad. There's a lot of domestic companies do it, but in terms of for youth travelers going abroad, it's quite fragmented and disjointed, and we just want to make it into like your one-stop shop, really, to get a lot of travel booking services, like flights and accommodation, visas and things like that, just to become that encompassing work and travel platform. That's the goal.
But once we move past that growth phase, in 5 years' time, I can see myself having a position in the company. And I can see this company having offices in London. I can see running this company globally, as we always hoped for, and expanding in different departments, not just the entertainment industry, possibly other industries, the food industry, the travel industry. That's still to see, and that's still coming to the stages. But if we move past this year and we accomplish the goals that we had in mind, then yeah, I do see a very bright future in this company for myself. And I see us maybe eventually, after 5 years' time, getting to the valuation we want, either selling it off or moving forward and continuing to capture it.
We have a long-term vision of providing payments for business payments for all around the world. Also, thanks to all the new regulations that are coming now in Europe, like PTSD2, that allow you to access open data from different banks. So we see ourselves like a new challenger bank, all mobile, for like small business around the world. They can actually trade in multi-currencies, and they can send instant payments from India to US. So different countries. Yeah.